Hey guys, Darkbreaker here, and you won't believe it, I'm able to do a Vero review, the nearest hero from AOV in Indonesia, and I think they released a movie for him as well, and I already know kinda his kit from playing at King of Glory. They used the same skills for him, but use the character design from a movie star or something like that. I'm not really sure, but let's see what he can do. So first, his passive. Vero's training has reached a new level, increasing his armor and magic defense. When Vero is near death, his health is restored by 60%. Wow, that's so good. And he is immobilized for 4.5 seconds, okay. During which he loses 25% armor and magic defense, and 3 insignias appear around him. When Vero, when touched by an ally hero, each insignia restores 10% HP to Vero and the hero. Oh fuck, oops. To Vero and the hero. After all three insignias have been activated, or at the end of 4.5 seconds, Vero deals 100 plus 100% of AD magic damage to nearby enemies and reduces their movement speed. He also gains 50% attack speed and 30% movement speed for 5 seconds. This effect can only be triggered once every 90 seconds. Ooh, that sounds really good, to be honest. Like, if you're a warrior in a team fight. Okay, his first skill, Vero resets his normal attack and enhances his 3 next normal attacks with each strike dealing additional 100 plus 20% physical damage. The third strike knocks the target in the air for 0.74. It's similar to Lubu, and when maxing, it cooldown goes down as well. Okay, let's see his second skill. Tornado Fist. Vero charges toward the target direction, but will be stopped if he runs into an obstacle, dealing 100 plus 40% physical damage to enemies along. Oh my god. along the way. If enemies are knocked into an obstacle, they take 50% additional damage and are stunned for 1 second. If Vero runs into an enemy building. What? The building takes damage? Okay. LOL, what the fuck? This guy does with his charge more damage to towers. And they stun. So you have a knockup, you have a stun. His passive, he's restoring HP. He's immobile during the HP gain. And he can be healed while being attacked. And after that, he gets attack speed and movement speed. Once every 90 seconds, okay. And his ultimate, oh my god, so popular, by the way. Vero charges for a short period of time, during which he can move, and 80% of the cooldown is returned if the ability is cancelled, okay. Then smashes his axe into the ground, dealing 300 plus 150% physical damage to enemies nearby and knocking them in the air. Another CC, so you have 1 second knockup, 1 second knockup, and 1 second stun, 0.75 second knockup. Wow. The longer the charging time, the larger the range and higher the damage. Each okay, you can charge. Passive. After learning this ability, Vero's abilities and enhanced normal attacks deal additional. What the fuck? Okay, ground AOE. Okay, cooldown. Well, cooldown is really low. Max CDR. Wow, that's so low actually. You can keep spamming the ultimate. Okay, let's hop right into the trial and check him out. I'm kinda excited. I think this hero will be, for you guys who don't know yet, I'm side laner for Team Bubble. Or Bubble Team. And I think this hero will be so good for side lane. for solo lane, especially. Okay, AI gets buffed as well. Wait, what is the settings? I can't. Ooh, ooh. Okay, enhance auto attacks. 1, 2. Okay. Lol. 1, 2, 3. Not stun. Let's just check the skills out. Get some gold. Boom, boom. So first skill and enhance auto attacks, and the third strike is a knock up. Second skill, a charge against the opponent who gets stunned. Let's see how much damage do I do to towers. Not that much. Okay, I need minions. Let me reread the ultimate again. During which you can move and smash us. Okay, I charge my axe, I put it down. Ooh, it does more damage to the long and loaded. Each enemy that gets maxable. Wow, okay, I see. Okay, let's check this out. Oh, I see you need to press it and then. Okay, let's check it out. Maybe give me some gold. Let's charge and then boom. I need to get some damage so we can see the passive of Vero. How low do I have to get? Increasing. What? Give me a second. Let me check. Hero's training has reached and when he's near death. What? I'm near death. What's happening here, guys? Okay, I didn't get this. Okay, let's see. Oh fuck. I forgot. I always need to press the ultimate longer and then I can release it. Boom! Yeah, you know, you guys know in King of Glory, this hero is very strong. Like, he's always picked in tournaments. I wonder how strong he will be in AoV. But I think his kit is so strong, like he has so much CC. Either way, you can play him solo lane or abyssal lane. I think abyssal lane is really good because you can provide so much CC for your team. Like, he is a better version of Arduin, basically. And Arduin is already a very popular pick. Okay, I wish I could build. Wait, can I? Oh, okay, let's see. Let's build. Let's see how I would build him. To be honest, it's probably a double burn build. Like, with this ultimate and this, you can do so much burn damage. Yeah, usually you get spear or you get rank breaker. But this guy doesn't have that much burst damage, I guess, so I would go for the more sustain. Let me give some gold. Okay, Omni. Then I would get magic defense, and probably last item is usually depending on the enemy, what they're building. You can build Muramasa, you can build Medallion of Troy, or you build this. This is probably the most consistent build for him. So let's try this out. Okay, wait, without this. Oh wait. Let me think. Yeah, flicker. You can either go flicker or you go double. Like if you go smart, you can go Leviathan and get double burn build on him, since he's like the typical tanky warrior bruiser. Like he's like Lubu with more CC. Pretty much, like his kid, the way you play him, except that he provides more. Yeah, he provides more CC. But he's like the typical warrior. Well, actually, I just crit so much. Maybe I could try crit on him. Oh wow, bad bot. Triple kill, oh my god. Quad kill! Getting the mega kill for the clickbait thumbnail. Easy, clap. Mega kill! Oh fuck, I mistimed. Okay, let's. Oh wait, let me try the full AD ultimate charge. Lol. How dare you, boy? Okay, let's try the full AD maximum damage build. Let me check. I want enough burst. Maybe if I crit him. I just need one lucky crit. Okay. Fenrir for sure. Oh my god. Don't fucking ride me. Stop it. Stop. I'm recording, boy. Let me think. I want more crit, right? Slicks 35. 100 physical damage. Or I just get another. Yeah. I just need one crit. Okay, that was not bad. Let's level up the thing for a second. Boom, boom, boom. Oops. Come back, baby! Where are you? Boom. Okay. Oh my god, you are fucking annoying, Thane. One, two. Again, what the fuck? Okay, yes. No. Boom. Lord. I think you could actually play him in fucking crypto. Okay, wait, guys, let me get out and try jungle. Let me try jungle for a second. Maybe that works out as well. Custom match. Yeah, custom match. Mm. I hope I'm not lagging custom match, I'm not sure. Yeah, let's try it out. Where's Vero? Here, Vero. Smite, Persona. Lol, what? Oh, she has double gun as well. Lol, quit page. Ooh, wow, nice pages. This is pretty good. Yeah, let's just try. No, I want some crit. I want some crit. How many seconds do I still have? Crit damage. She has a crit damage page. Oh, hello, boy. One crit. We wanted to try crit damage, right? But I need some. I need armor pen. Physical pierce. Yeah, crit. Yeah, this is good. This is good patron. It's approved by me, it's good. Let's see. Vero jungle is a viable or not? Yeah, I think I need to skill the first skill. Let's start blue buff. Let's see how quick my clear is on it. 9 seconds, that's pretty long to be honest. Wow, that's pretty quick attack speed for him. Ooh, I like it. I like it. Oh boys, you already know. Your boy is playing Vero jungle as well. First video will be Vero jungle, and second I will do a legit side lane build. But I'm not sure. You can go. Actually, you can go every jungle item on him. Like Soul Reaver works, the bow works as well, or Leviathan, or Leviathan, I don't know how to pronounce it. But since he's melee, yeah, maybe double burn, or you go Soul Reaver, Rank Breaker, Omni. Actually, the clear is not that quick. Let's try it out, boys. Oh shit! This hero is fucking nice! What the fuck? Lol. Did you see the combo? I'm in love already. I'm in love with this hero. And very high base damage stats. Like, I can easily do the dragon alone without a problem. Yeah. No, that's so nice. I think I covered everything. I tried him out, his skills, and if he's viable, yeah, in my opinion, best role for him is a Slayer lane. But he's viable in Abyss as well. And yeah, I guess you can play. I like in ranked, you can play him for sure for jungle. But he's not the quickest, let's say. But I think his gank is pretty strong because he provides so much CC. And you can push people back into the tower. Like, oh guys, you know what? You do flicker over the person and then you can push him right into your team. Or you use it to push them right into the tower. And then they are stunned when you're pushing them back, right? And then you can use this combo, they are getting stunned as well, knocked up as well. Lol, he's so good. And his ultimate, if I'm charging, at the end, he's getting knocked up. Okay, let's... Oh, I can't reset that base. So I push him back. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm done with the review for him. He's a really good hero, and I think he will be one of my main heroes in the future. I hope you guys enjoyed this review of the newest Indonesian hero. If you guys liked it, of course, leave a like and subscribe if you don't want to miss out on any future update, any future videos. See ya. Bye bye. Yeah.